happened. I just wanted to try to get it loose for him, but he clamped down on me like a vice grip. And I'm going to tell you what, if anybody's coming this way from anywhere, they better be ready to meet the man they call me. It has been a wacky, what a night we got going here.
Yeah, that Ultimate Fight stuff is one thing. WCW is another. This is where the big boys play. And I had a chance not too long ago to be in Japan and watch some of the Ultimate Fight stars compete in an event called K1, which is essentially a no-holds-barred kickboxing event. And I saw guys like Kimo get knocked out in the first round. One of the guys from the Gracie School of Jiu-Jitsu, I don't think he lasted 8 seconds. So it's one thing to venture in their territory. It's another thing to step into somebody else's backyard. And if you step into WCW's backyard, you might be facing this man. And I'll tell you what, he is lethal.
I'll tell you what, he is so lethal. Every blow that he throws takes his toll on a man. Every time he kicks you, and if he kicks you in the right place, I mean, it is lights out. You can turn out the light. The party's over. Right here. Whoa!
Oh, man!
Yes.
Standing sidekick right on the point of the chin, and that has got to be it. The referee should count this guy out. Get him out of here. He is in trouble.
Make no mistake about it. Mighty Meng, handled by Kunapaka, telling you this guy has to be dealt with. What an awesome kick. What an awesome power. What an awesome individual he is. And we are taking a look at WCW. Yeah, this man might here be the strongest of them all, right down here on Speed Street.
Oh, wait a minute. They're telling me in the truck that I'm going to do an interview with Meng.
There you
and
go.
Parker. No, no. Meng and Parker said, I don't know if he's in the mood or not. Meng is still upset. Let's take another look at that. Look at that kick right on the chin.
What a kick that was. I tell you, I'd like to see that. You going to interview him or not?